Hello. I'm overjoyed to see you. You've been back to Kelswick several times since our first visit. You seem different. You're more comfortable, I can tell. How are you? So happy to hear that you're doing well, my friend. I must admit, when I hadn't seen you in several days, I did get a tad nervous, but I spoke with a few of my animal friends in the forest, and they said not to be afeared, that you were popping about North Briar and making all kinds of friends and having all kinds of adventures. When I heard you met Kelkith, kin of the great Kells of yore, I was nothing short of flibbergibbered. Is it true? Did you really meet the Kelkith? The Romad? I am so impressed with your courage. She can frighten even the bravest of us. Yes, I'm including myself in that. Although, when I have had the fortune of being in her company, I found it quite agreeable. I'm sure you have much to do, but do you mind if we rest here for a bit? I've been searching for you, and I haven't had much of a chance to rest. This is a nice part of the wood. I don't come here as often as I should. It's quite beautiful, don't you think? I heard you met Felden the Farrier. What did you make of her? She is a funny one. I like her as well. I do. She's fierce, but kind. It's a combination I like. I am sweet, but feisty. Somewhat similar. It's almost like... like different cuts of the same cake. And how about Tally? You visited her as well? Oh, good. Yes. I do so love her thimbleberry treacle. What did you have to eat? Mm. Oh, this. Got a bit of my teeth, I think. This is an acorn fruit. It's quite delicious. Tastes sort of like a sweet. It very, very dry. Apple. And the Oracle of Ardendale. This is a most special experience. She is the wisest in the land. I've heard of her greatness since I was an elf child. I'm so very glad you have so much support here. It's quite refreshing to hear. Everyone seems to have welcomed you with open arms. That doesn't always happen. I'm glad. I'm very glad, my friend. I must admit, when first we met, I was a bit nervous about you. But I'm very, very glad that you've settled in, that you have so much. So many friends here. So many friends here already. It's because you are very special. Not just because you're an earth dweller, but because you're special. You are. You're very, very special. And what did you make of the Oracle? Were you a bit frightened? I feel that that's understandable. She has quite a presence, doesn't she? You're right about that. Oh, how did I know to find you here? Well, I heard from a few sparrows that Kelkith was taking a foreigner to see the Oracle of Ardendale, and I just knew it was you. So, I packed up my satchel, and I came along. I've been walking for days now, but I'm so glad I found you. Here you are. Oh, I'm feeling much better, thank you. I whipped up this tonicular tonic. And that's been immensely helpful. For my ankle, for my leg, for my arm as well. Both of them, in fact. It's been quite the lifesaver. I do like finding things out in nature that can help you. I think there's a special kind of magic like that. Dracula is lovely for wounds, burns, rashes, that kind of thing. Although, I really doubt that you have any troubles like that. I have a little bit of trouble walking long distances. Traveling very far, but other than that, I'm quite all right. And in a matter of days, I shall be right as rhubarb. It's very pungent. Would you like a sniff? Go on. Yeah. I know. I like getting a whole breath full as well. It's funny how it does that. Bubbles. Tripling. Oh no, the journey wasn't bad at all. No. I had Aoife the falcon with me as well. She's quite a lovely travelling companion, so really was no trouble at all. And it was well worth it to travel here to see you. So, what's the plan? What did the oracle tell you? Well, I know you probably shouldn't tell me exactly what she told you, but how can I help? Oh, that's quite all right. I'm sure you're not meant to know right now what exactly to do next. Would you like to head back to Northbriar? Go to my tree? We could rest up, have some food. Oh, Pip! Oh, that'd be lovely. I restocked the pantry. Well, I was thinking that maybe you'd pay me a visit, or I'd come find you. And I wanted to make sure to have all kinds of goodies waiting. Oh. Oh, Crocus. What a pattern. Thank you. we should stay here until it lets up. Perhaps we should huddle underneath this lily leaf. I do so love the sound of rain. Fills me with the tinklies. Do you know what I mean? The tinklies. Does rain give you the tinklies? Well, I'm glad to hear it. I suppose this isn't really all that bad then. Not bad at all. Do you know? I may have a few Kaluna cakes in my satchel. If you're hungry. Yes. My arms are getting a bit tired. Maybe I can fasten. Somehow rested on a few boughs above us. Let me see what I can do. All right. That should do it. Are you getting rained on at all? Oh, good. Then it's working. The lily leaf lives. Those Kaluna cakes. This is where I keep all of my acorn fruit. Like to see inside. Lovely. Just a bit of twine. Little bed. That one will be for the little forest creatures. Ours will have to be the next one. Have you ever had acorn fruit? Yes, it's interesting. A dry apple. If it weren't so sweet, it would feel like we shouldn't be eating this. Would you like one? No. Give it a try. They're usually yellow. When they're yellow, I like to call them sun drops. But as they ripen, they turn this reddish brown. Looks like it's going bad. And they're quite hard. But they really are lovely. No, it doesn't smell. But here you are. There you go. Now let's have our Kaluna cakes. Don't worry, I've got one for you. And one for me. Driving you wild. It's not a bad Kaluna cake, is it? You take this one. There we are. And I'll take this one. I love Kaluna cakes. The only trouble is, I wish that you could have them more than just once a month. Because Kaluna cakes can only really be made on a full moon. Try making a Kaluna cake on a new moon. Disaster. Although I like the idea that you can only have it once a month, really. Makes it all the more special. Cheers. Just melts in the mouth, doesn't it? you think. You won't hurt my feelings, I promise. I'm so glad. A Kaluna cake with my dear friend. The rain falling all around. Pitter-patter. Pitter-patter of the rain. I don't think it could get much cozier than this, do you? I have a flagon of fig nectar in my satchel. It's made from the same figs that are atop our Kaluna. Do you like a swig? I would as well. Must have fallen off. Don't think I'm crazy. Sounded like an echo. Mead. Sounds like cherry blossom somehow. So glad you like all the things that I've shared with you so far. You're either very, very polite, which I know you are, or you just happen to have great taste. Kaluna cakes are legendary in my treehouse. Speaking of, to get back to mine, Grumdiddlyumly. When I was a wee elf, no more than hedgerow high, my favourite pastime, sitting underneath the weeping willows, a wisteria wood, listening to the pitter patter of the raindrops on a rainy day. As soon as I heard the first pattering rainfall, I used to sneak into our pantry and pocket a slice of Lindy loaf. Cozies into our library from the study. And I'd sneak one of the dusty old tomes from the ancient shelf. Usually one about the fairies of Veldrock or Findlewood Forest. I would don my Galdorian cloak. They're rain resistant, you see. Galdorian cloak would be awful useful today, wouldn't it? And I'd head for those weeping trees in that wood that smelled so strongly. Those vines for which it was named. Wisteria. To this day, even the slightest whiff of wisteria brings me straight back to my elfhood. You nostalgic. I'm very nostalgic. I would just sit there, huddled underneath a willow, reading about the fairy world, which I wanted so badly to visit. I just knew that if I visited the fairies, fell draw or found a wood for it, then I could make a friend. I just knew it. I knew they would understand me. This seems very similar. Although now I do have a friend. And the loveliest friend in all of Kelswake. And probably beyond. Do you have many friends? Well, I'm very lucky to be sitting here with you. Hear that? Do you know what that is? The merfolk of Maplebrook. They dwell in the deep waters, and when the clouds decide that it's time for a sprinkling over the land like we have now, well, they pick up a bit of the water, smatter over the rest of Kelswake. And sometimes a merchild or two will get caught up in the deluge. This is the call to their kin. The chorus beckons their brethren, beckons them forth in boats of bubbles, bearing mernarks, mermen, mermaids, to come collect their kith and bring them safely home. I've heard tell of the mystic music, but try as I might, I've never heard it myself. It's beautiful, isn't it? Something lonesome and enchanting about their refrain. Makes me feel lonesome and peaceful all at once. You hear that? They've been found. Oh. angelic voices, but I'd be lying if I said it wasn't making me melancholy. I'm glad they're safe. Soon they'll be back in Maplebrook's cascading waters. Home again, didgeridoo. Boats of bubbles collecting their kin. Boats of bubbles collecting their kin. Can you imagine being rescued on a boat of bubbles? Neither can I, but it sounds lovely. Have another swig of the fig nectar. Thank you. It's quite a nice flagon, isn't it? That's unboastful. It's mine after all. Everything all right? You seem to be lost in thought. You're worried about your quest. Yes, I can understand that. Well, would you like it if instead of going back to my tree, just stayed here, tried to figure out a plan together? Oh, you'd like to pay Felden another visit? A blacksmith. For weapons? No? For armor? Ah, I see. Yes. Well, I'm sure Felden would be very happy with a little bit of extra help, as usual. I'm sure that she'll make sure that you get exactly what you need. As long as you maybe help her here and there a little bit. It doesn't really look like this rain is going to let up anytime soon, does it? Would you like to sleep here? Well, I've got a twinkle torch and a few silken swathes. We could rest here and then we could head to Felden's first thing tomorrow morning. How does that sound? Just you one of the silken swaths. Put this away from us. Here's one of the silken swaths. They're really quite cozy. Ah, feels so so soft and they're very heavy. The funny thing about silken swaths, because they're elf-made, they're rather clever. So, as you look at them, as you hold them, they're very light. They don't feel very warm. But once you put them on you, they grow heavy. Almost as if they are giving you a hug. This shall be very, very, very cozy. And you one. Here you are. There we go. Don't want it, it's quite long. Don't want it to fall. Here you are. Now, let me see if I can perhaps fashion some cuddly cots out of the underbrush. All right. Well, I think this should be just fine. finish off that flagon, and then we go to sleep. All right. Why don't we pass it back and forth between the two of us? What's your favorite day? Your favorite day. Your favorite day that you've ever had. My favorite day is today. This is my happiest day. Can't imagine anything I'd rather be doing. It's the best day of my life. So thank you. There's only room for one. I mean, there's only some left for one. It's yours, friend. Go on then. Alright. Let's go to sleep, shall we? I shall stay awake until you nod off, just to make sure that we're safe. Plus, I don't think I could sleep even if I wanted.